Welcome back. Our closing moment here, and we have popular comedian, also known as comedian, whose intellect keeps people glued to their seats, regarded as one of the brightest comedians to come out of the South, has his sights set on changing the world. I'm reading, besides being renowned comedian, he also performed in other parts of the world, including his state.
That's other parts of the world.
Other parts of the world. Okay, please, he was born in Port Harcourt, born, bred, buttered, and sandwiched in Port Harcourt, went to Aladum. Hold on. Please, can you hear me pronounce this?
Aladumo.
Yeah.
Okay. And he has a...
I was born in Port Harcourt.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Aladumo. He has a degree in linguistics and communication studies. Okay. Daniel the Humorous People.
That's actually 3 pages. I don't know why you're summarizing it.
No, but the thing is
very long.
Hold on. After every
from
two...
From primary school, you just went straight to university. What happened to my secondary school?
After every...
Tell us.
My now problem. It looks as if I'm too intelligent from primary. They just moved me to
That's
university.
That's the problem with right. you. How can you that every two... After every two words is comedian. Popular, yeah. comedian. Daniel, comedian. Also known as comedian.
Well,
you don't have any other life.
Well, no, I have a few others, but that's
you have
like,
a few other lives.
Yeah, depending on some situations I face, you can switch. Because, I mean, if boys hold you somewhere and point you some things, you don't need jokes at that point. You need prayers. So you have to now move to your evangelistic side. But, well, that's who I am. That's what I am. That's almost all of what I am. Okay. Just more than I remain.
Now, please tell us how you suddenly switched from linguistics to making people laugh.
I think it's even the other way around. It's actually the other way around.
Oh,
yeah, because
okay.
I knew as a growing child that I was going to do entertainment. I already saw myself, but I didn't know if I was going to be a musician or a dancer. And I tried all of them. I tried music, I tried dancing. A lot of people do not believe, but I'm amongst the founding members of Spirit of David. I tried several. I even tried to be a DJ.
You know, I know one of the leaders of Spirit of the. I can call him now. Ask him.
Pastor Sheggs.
Uh-huh.
Shegulawa. He knows me.
Oh, how do you even call his name?
P. Sheggs, of course. So, you know, and a lot of people don't believe, like, which time you followed Spirit of the as you did like this? Well, there was a time like that, throwback. You know.
So the question is, do you still dance?
In my mind. Like, I can picture it.
Okay.
So I picture it and give other people. I don't like problem.
Why did you stop dancing?
No, I didn't stop. It was more like I was, like, on a path to discovery. You know, from music, no work. Did this, you know, work. I knew I just belonged to that field. And then I started doing comedy. In fact, when I started doing comedy, I started from the church. It was more like, that dancer, that's funny. You know?
Ah.
But then it now became like, you know, a lot more people started wanting me to come and crack jokes. Than dance. Because they saw that, okay, maybe I was a lot more better there. And so I found out I just started investing more of my time and energy and creativity and all into comedy. And then somehow that dance part just, you know.
So, but if dance came along now, you would
dance. Yeah, at the right price and motivation, we might revisit that. Yeah.
What would motivate you to dance?
Well, if there's some kind of production or some kind of show, just to show the world the other side, but it's dominantly comedy. So moving to linguistics was more like, okay, what kind of comedian do I want to be? What kind of people do I want to reach? And I found out, okay, look, I think I want to be a lot more global. I want to cut across, you know, various audiences or spectrum, as it were. And a lot of people were like, oh, do theater arts. Oh, most comedians do theater arts. But for me, I think I wasn't really into the whole body language thing. I was more of communicating. How do I want to talk to this person and talk to that person and all of that? So, which was what influenced my choice to study linguistics and communications.
Interesting.
See, all this, he has just...
Kondila has given a seminar like this.
Keynote speech. Keynote address. Okay, but... Let's look at something. Okay, you chose comedy. Now, there are a lot of people out there who believe that most of the comedians just tell other people's jokes. They hardly tell their own jokes. I mean, How does that work, and how do you take that?
Yeah, it's very, it's one of the downsides of the industry, one of the downsides of the business, you know. But I think in every other business, you have the originals and you always have the fakes, you always have the imitators and co, you know. And sometimes when I complain about these things, one of my colleagues at Capella, he'll say, now these kind of people, they make us last for this business, because the people will know that, okay, these are the originals. These are, it's painful. It's very, very painful. And it's even much more painful now that we have Instagram comedians, we have skit comedians. So they hear us tell the jokes, and then they now go and act it into skits. And these skits move faster than the stand-up set. Because when you're with your phone, you may likely not just want to watch one man holding the mic and talking, but you love, your eyes will love to see, you know, activity. Maybe the comedian is saying, one man did this to the woman, and the woman did this and that. It's funny, but then these other guys will now go and carry it, act it. So you will love to see the man actually doing the thing to the woman doing back, instead of, you know, hearing it and stressing you to imagine what the guy is saying.
So are you an Instagram comedian?
No, I'm not.
Stand-up comedian.
I'm a stand-up comedian, and I always give it to them when I see them. So you Instagram people will soon push you from this world.
But you're on Instagram too.
Yeah, I'm on Instagram, but that's the thing. Them now, they're on Instagram, but they can't come on stage. If they come on stage, they will jokes.
So how do you get your own jokes? And please don't tell me from everyday life.
Well, okay, you get that a lot, but the truth of the matter is actually from everyday life. But not necessarily from, not everyday life.
I said, don't tell me.
Where is the answer now? I can't tell you. Well, it's not from life from Monday to Sunday. It's, for me, it's more like what you expose yourself to. The kind of things you read, the kind of things you watch, the kind of places you go.
You read?
Well, one day you come to my house, I'll show you my bookshelf. Haven't you seen Alibaba's bookshelf?
No, Alibaba. I'm actually waiting for Alibaba to see if he'll tell us, because I know Alibaba reads.
Now you show us road finish. Show us road finish, because that's the thing. You're going to certain places. There are some kind of places you go to perform. You can't be telling them about something that happened in Makoko. You go to places that these people don't know Makoko. They only know about Trump and Brian Tracy and one or two things. So you have to be on that level with him. When you go to your Makoko guys, who relate there as well. When we come to Lekki too, we'll be on that level as well.
There's that concern about how viable this industry is. I mean, that it would only be for a certain time. I mean, we have the, let's just say, some people say comedy began from the court jesters of old. And right now, you hardly find court jesters in existence anymore.
You hardly find courts.
So, so there's that concern about how viable this industry would be going into, is it the 20 what century?
Second
century. But before you get to that point, we'll take a moment and we'll come back. You answer that question.
All right.
Don't go away.
Global copy. Congo restaurant. I should just enter. So what do you want? Hello, duh. Like, seriously, are you kidding me? Can I see your menu? The guy said, okay, we need a quarter now. He gave the girl menu. The girl ordered for rice and fish. The waiter mistakenly brought rice and chicken. Now their problem starts. He said, come, are you stupid? Like, seriously, are you that stupid? Are you that dumb? Like, your skull is empty. Like, there's nothing in your head. I told you fish, you're bringing chicken. Fish and chicken, do they look the same? Fish and chicken, like, dog, do they look the same? I told you bring fish, you're bringing chicken. Don't you know what fish is? Simple fish, F-I-S-S, fish, you don't know. My friends have been complaining